Hi there and welcome to another session of business studies with me Vishwanath sir for the 11th standard. We last talked up with how the small business industries help the entire economy in a different number of ways. Today we shall go into how the government assistance happens to these small industries and small business units. So we shall take up from here where we last left off. The small-scale industries have bridged the gap between the rural and the urban India by providing various employment opportunities. The small-scale industries have decreased the migration from the rural to the urban areas, developed regions across the country, promoted exports and has eliminated the income inequalities. Considering the contribution of the small industries towards the country's social economic development, the government of India through the 5-year plans and the industrial policies have emphasized for the formulation and implementation of various policies to be established, promote and develop small industries sector, especially the backward or the less developed areas. The government provides significant package of incentives to attract the industries in the backward area. Okay, so if you realize that India is yet dwelling in these backward regions, and these backward regions development is very imperative if you want to see the growth of the entire country. If you want to see the development of the entire country, it starts from the villages, it starts from the farming industries, it starts from the agricultural based industries and anything product related to agriculture. So let us go through the various incentives or assistance which the government provides. Number one, infrastructure. Apart from providing infrastructure in form of industrial estates for small scale industries, every state government provides developed land in rural or hilly areas at very low rate to encourage setting up of the enterprises in backward areas. So what happens in this process is that that area gets developed, and in the process of the area getting developed, automatically the country also gets developed. Okay, so going further from here onwards, they provide power and water free in the initial areas, and they provide them certain facilities with very concessional rates in the later years ahead. Finance, the government runs various schemes to which finance helps to the small scale industries to provide them with either or without any collateral securities at a very low rate of interest. It provides subsidies at 10 to 15% for building capital assets. Okay, so this is the benefit which they get, which usually they wouldn't have got if they would have focused in other regions. As far as technology is concerned, the government also provides assistance to small industries to enhance productivity and to reduce production cost. Training. The government has formulated various policies under which the individuals running small industries are provided with training to the latest techniques of production, marketing, finance and overall managing of business. Procurement of raw materials, labor, etc. Small scale industries are allocated raw materials and other resources at concessional rates and on priority basis. Okay, then also the government gives them tax exemptions, tax holidays. They are exempted from state sales tax, especially the small industries which are there in the union territories. The government has also abolished octroi and exemption of a sales tax period for 5 years. So this is basically how does the government help the small industries? First, in terms of infrastructure, so they set it up for them and they provide land and other facilities at a very cheap rate. In the initial years, the power and the water are provided free of cost, and later on they are provided at a very concessional rate, which helps them decrease the cost of production. The finance is also provided by them at a very low rate, and some of them don't have even collateral security. Okay, going further, the rate of they provide subsidies to 10 to 15% of the capital enterprises. They provide technology, they provide training, and they also provide procurement of raw materials and labor at very concessional rates and on priority basis. Besides this, they offer also tax exemptions to these people, and especially those who are there in the union territory, the small industries are exempted from sales tax altogether. Okay, so that is the government assistance to small industries from and small business units. From here we go to the government institutions and schemes for the small scale industries. And the government's main objective is to see that there is optimum utilization of local resources. Okay, because local resources we don't have to spend on imports, and the waiting period is also not there. To develop the rural India, the government has formed various agencies, departments and corporations under the Ministry of Small Scale Industries. Let us discuss the various schemes and support measures followed by them, which leads to the promotion of the small and the rural industries. Okay, first, the institutions providing support to the MSME, that is the micro, small, medium enterprises. Number one is the National Small Industries Corporation, NSIC. It was established in 1955 to promote and aid the foster growth of small business units in the country. The main functions of the NSIC is to develop the small scale industries as ancillary units to the large scale industries. Okay, so we know that ancillary unit is a small unit as compared to the parent body. It also helps to develop the plant and equipment to the small scale industries on a higher purchase basis. This helps develop the enterprises to promote and stores purchase program of the central government for the fast development of the small scale industries to assist the small industries in marketing their products, to procure and supply, distribute ingenious and imported raw material, to import and provide components for the parts which is required in specific industries, to construct industrial estates and run the prototype production training centers, that is vestibular training, where you provide hands-on training, to export products of small business units and to develop export worthiness, serve as technology business incubators, develop software technology parks and technology transfer centers, and also to sensitize small industries through credit rating, the performance and credit rating system. Okay, so this all is done by the National Small Scale Industries Corporation. It's better we go through the points again so that you understand it better. It was established in 1955 to promote and aid foster growth of small business industries in the country. The main function of the NSIC, that is the National Small Scale Industries Corporation, is to develop the small scale industries as ancillary units to large scale industries, to provide plant and equipment to small scale industries on higher purchase basis, to help the enterprise participate in the stores purchase program of the central government for faster development of the small scale industries, also to assist the small scale industries in marketing their products, to procure, supply and distribute the indigenous and imported raw materials, to see that these components and parts are required by the specific users in the specific industries to construct industrial estates, establish and run prototype production cum service centers, or what you will have learnt or what you will learn in the future as vestibule training center, where hands-on training is provided to export products of small business units and develop export worthiness. Service technology business incubators, develop software technology parks and technology transfer centers to sensitize small industries through the credit rating, through the performance and credit rating system. Okay, so this was the small industries under the National Small Scale Industries Corporation. Today when we finished, we did government assistance to small scale industries, and we also went through a little bit of depth where we found certain institutions. In fact, we only took up one institution today, that is the National Small Scale Industries Corporation, NSIC. Okay, please go through these points and revise, which will help you understand the chapter much better. Thank you so much. This is Vishwanath sir signing off.